Hello learners, welcome back to my channel Shraddha's Physics. In this lecture we will discuss about the self inductance and mutual inductance. So according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, the change in the magnetic flux linked with a coil produces an EMF in a coil. So in a closed circuit, the current will be produced. Suppose this is your galvanometer and it is connected to the coil. This is the closed circuit. So this current carrying coil, it produces a magnetic field. So when this field get in contact or linked to the coil, the magnetic flux is produced. So current carrying coil produces magnetic field, and when this field gets in contact to the coil, the magnetic flux will be produced. So when a battery, suppose let us draw another diagram. So when a battery is connected to the coil, a magnetic field is produced, so flux is linked to the coil. So the flux linked to the coil. This is the current I, suppose the current I. So I can write that the change in flux, if the flux is changed, so this is because of the magnetic field phi equal to B dot A. This is the flux linked to the coil. The flux linked to the coil will be this much. This flux also depends on the magnetic field and area of the coil. We can say the flux depends on magnetic field and area of the coil. So the magnetic field we can write B will be equal to mu naught into Ni. So we can say that when here this suppose a switch is here, when the switch is on, the current value it rises from 0 to I. So we can say that the magnetic field also changes. So let us consider here when switched on, the current rises from 0 to I, 0 to the maximum value, suppose I. So we can say that so the magnetic field also changes. So the magnetic field also changes. When the field changes, the flux also changes. When the magnetic field changes, the flux linked to the coil or the flux also changes. Hence EMF will induced in it. This is the Faraday's law. So now we can define the self-inductance as, it is a phenomenon, self-inductance is a phenomenon due to which the change of current in a coil induce an EMF in the same coil. in the same coil. Same coil. So self-inductance is a phenomenon due to which the change of current in a coil induces an EMF in the same coil. So we can say that this phi, the flux phi, magnetic flux, is directly proportional to the current, or we can write it as, or this phi can be written as phi b equal to some proportionality constant L into I, since phi equal to b dot a and b equal to mu naught ni. So we can say that the flux is directly proportional to the current, or we can write phi equal to li. And here this L is called as, where this L equal to the coefficient of self inductance of the coil. L equal to the coefficient of self inductance of the coil. And here L will be equal to, we can write L equal to phi divided by I. So this L will be equal to phi divided by I. That means if I, the current is 1 ampere, so if current equal to 1 ampere, then L will be equal to phi. It means that if L equal to, here L equal to phi divided by I, it means that if the current is I equal to 1 ampere, then L equal to phi. Or we can say that if 1 ampere current is flowing through a coil, if 1 ampere current is flowing through a coil which produces a flux, let us say x, then x like 10, 20, whatever, then the coefficient of self inductance is x, or it may be if the value of phi means flux. If the value of flux is 10, then the self inductance will be 10 if 1 ampere current is flowing through the coil. So the current in a coil is, if the current in a coil is 1 unit, then the flux linked to the coil itself is the value of its self inductance. Now if I will consider the current through the coil is changes when the current in the coil when current in the coil when current in the coil coil changes changes the magnetic field B, the magnetic field, let us consider B, the magnetic field B also changes. So due to this flux, due to the change of the magnetic field, the flux also changes. Due to this flux link to it changes. Due to the change in flux, an EMF is induced in the same coil. Okay, an EMF is induced, so that EMF will be equal to EMF equal to minus d phi by dt, or this the value of phi is Li, so this will be minus d by dt of, in place of phi here I am writing Li. So this self-inductance L, this is the proportionality constant, can be taken as constant, taken outside to the derivative. This is the d by dt of I current. So the EMF can be written as, this is minus L di by dt. Or we can write the value of self-inductance equal to E divided by di by dt. This is, here I am considering only the magnitude part, di by dt. So this is the magnitude part here. Only we have considered the magnitude of L. Magnitude of L. It means that suppose it is a coil. If I change the current, through it, the magnetic field will change. So because of the change in the magnetic field, the flux linked to it will changes. And also we know from the Faraday's law that if there will be a change in the flux, then EMF will be induced in it. So that EMF that will be induced, it is just for the same coil. That is the current, if it is closed loop, if I will take it is a closed loop, and if I will flow a current through this coil, then because of this flow of current, there will be a magnetic field will develop. Because of this magnetic field, if the current changes, so the magnetic field will change. Because of that change, magnetic flux will change. And because of this change in magnetic flux, an EMF will be induced in that coil. That is known, this total phenomenon is called as the self-inductance. And here, this L equal to E divided by di by dt. Since L equal to E divided by di by dt, here I have considered only the magnitude, only magnitude part is considered. So if here I will consider this di by dt equal to 1, if this change of current is equal to 1, then the coefficient of self-inductance L will be equal to induced EMF. So here we can write, when current through a coil changes, at the rate of that is di by dt, at the rate of 1 ampere per second, then the value of EMF induced is equal to the value of self-inductance of the coil. Okay. So here, if di by dt equal to 1, that is the current through the coil is changing at the rate of 1 ampere per second, then the EMF induced is equal to the self-inductance, that is L. So L will be equal to E when di by dt equal to 1, from this expression, because L equal to E divided by di by dt. Now we will see the unit of self-inductance. From that expression, we will calculate the unit of self-inductance. We know L equal to E divided by di by dt. di by dt. And here the unit of self inductance is equal to Henry. This is your Henry, or we can write it as 1 millihenry. 1 millihenry equal to 1 millihenry is equal to 10^-3 henry. So Henry means in a coil if di by dt is 1 ampere per second and induced EMF is 1 volt, then its self inductance in a coil, is 1 henry. This is how we define Henry. This is the when di by dt equal to 1 and EMF will be equal to 1, then in that condition we can say that L will be equal to 1 Henry. Di by dt means current per second, 1 ampere per second, and E induced EMF E equal to 1 volt, then the self inductance will be equal to 1 Henry. So 1 Henry is equal to, this 1 Henry is equal to 1 volt divided by 1 ampere per second. Okay, now we'll see the dimension of L or the self inductance. Dimension of L. We know L equal to E divided by di by dt. And also E equal to W by IT. Because we know EMF will be equal to W divided by the charge Q. And you know the charge equal to, we can write the charge equal to current into time. We know. So we can write EMF equal to W divided by IT whole divided by this di by dt is the current divided by time. We are simply calculating the dimension here. So for the W we can write this is ML2T-2, this is the work done, divided by, for the current this is ampere and for the time this is T, into this is 1 by I by T, I means current divided by the time. Okay. Now this will be equal to ML2, and here the power of T is, this is T^-T and this is 1+1, 2. Sorry, this will be T^1 and T^1, they will get cancelled. And again A power, this will be T^-2 and here A^-2. So this is the dimensional formula for the L. And also we can calculate from L equal to 5 by I. We can also calculate from this expression. Okay. So whatever. So this dimension formula of L equal to ML2T^-2 and ampere^-2. Now we will see the derivation of the self inductance. Let us consider a solenoid of turn density. Solenoid of turn density is n, and the area of cross section is A. Area of cross section is A. The length is L. Current I is flowing through it. is flowing through it. Flowing through it. Here we have considered a solenoid having the number of turn density is small n and area of cross section is A. The length is L and the current I is flowing through it. So the magnetic field, the magnetic field B will be equal to mu naught Ni, and the flux linked with the coil will be equal to flux linked with it is equal to phi, that is equal to B dot A. This is for one turn of the coil. One turn of the coil, flux linked with one turn of a coil. One turn of a coil B phi equal to B dot A, and that is equal to mu naught Ni dot A. Now the flux linked with all the coils, all the turns, the flux linked with all turns will be equal to all turns, that is NL, that is equal to mu naught Ni A into NL. This is suppose capital phi, here I am writing capital phi, this is the small phi, here is the total flux is capital phi. This will be mu naught Ni A into NL, or simply we can write it as this will be equal to mu naught N square I A into L. This is the total flux phi. Here L is the length of the coil. L is the length of the coil. Now we can write this self inductance as L equal to phi by I. This is the capital phi. Or this can be written as mu naught N square I A L divided by I. So I A get cancelled. So this implies this self inductance can be written as mu naught N square A L. This is the self inductance. And now we can write this capital N here. Let capital N equal to the total number of turns, that is equal to NL. That is, if N is the number of turns, number of turn density, this small n is the number of turn density. So density equal to this N equal to actually number of turns divided by the length L. So we can write number of turns will be equal to N into L. So this is equal to this capital N equal to, this is the total number of turns. Total number of turns. And this small n equal to turn density, or we can write number of turns per unit length. Unit length. Okay. So we can write n equal to nl, or n square will be equal to n square l square. So now this l will becomes, this can be written as l will be equal to mu naught in place of n square l. If I multiply l and divide l, this will be capital N square a divided by l. This is the expression for the self inductance. So we can say that this self inductance is related to the length. Now let us see one thing. If the number of turn density is constant, that is in this case, if n equal to constant, then in that case L will be directly proportional to the length of the coil. But if capital N is constant, that is the number of turns of the coil is constant, so in that case you can see the self inductance is inversely proportional to the length L. Here this is inversely proportional to the length L. In this case you can see the length is inversely proportional, the self inductance is inversely proportional to the length L. or if I will consider the number density, the number of turn density, that is the number of turns per unit length of the coil is constant, then in that case the self inductance will be proportional to the length, directly proportional to the length. This is the difference between when n constant, directly self inductance directly proportional to the length of the coil. If the number of turns of the coil is constant, then the self inductance will be inversely proportional to the length L. So this is clear to you. Now we will see mutual inductance, that is mutual inductance of the coil. So in case of the mutual inductance, let us consider a coil first. This is first coil 1, and another coil is placed on the same axis, just like that, just like this. Okay, this is suppose coil 2. Okay, the coil 1, that is the blue one, and the pink one, that is the coil 2, they are placed on the same axis. They are placed at the one axis. A coil 1 is taken, let me write, coil 1 is taken and another coil 2 is taken by giving insulation so that by supplying current to one coil, the magnetic flux must be linked to the other coil. And here you should note that the coil 1 and 2 are placed on one axis. So it means that the two coils are placed on one axis, so that the change of current in one coil, it will induce an EMF in the other coil. So this phenomenon is called as the mutual induction. Suppose in this blue one, suppose if I will connect it to a battery, and this one is my switch, and here it is a closed loop. If I will switch on this blue one, that is this coil 1, suppose this one is coil 1. When a current will flow through this coil, an induced EMF will be developed in another coil, this one, suppose the pink one. Here it is connected to a galvanometer, suppose here. They are placed on one axis. So this particular phenomenon is called as the mutual induction. This is the mutual induction. That is, when a current will be varying, the current will vary in one coil, then in another coil, the induced EMF will be developed. This particular phenomenon is called as the mutual induction. So here, this phenomenon is called as mutual inductance. Suppose if current in coil 1 is I1, a magnetic field is produced, a magnetic field is produced in the coil 1, a magnetic field is produced. So due to this magnetic field, a flux is linked with the second coil. A flux will be linked with the second coil, with the coil 2. So let that flux be phi 2. Because of the second coil, here I am writing, let it be phi 2. So here we know the phi is proportional to the current in the first coil, that is coil 1. So phi 2 will be proportional to I 1, or we can write it as this phi 2 will be equal to the proportionality constant M into I 1. This M is called, where M equal to the coefficient of mutual inductance, coefficient of mutual inductance for this set of coil, mutual inductance, coefficient of mutual inductance for this set of coil, for this set of coil. Set of coil means the two coil. So here we can write this M as M21, that is equal to phi 2 divided by I 1. Phi 2 divided by I 1. And also we can write M12 will be equal to phi 1 divided by I 2. This M21 can be read as, this is the mutual inductance. M21 is the mutual inductance in the second coil due to the first coil. And similarly, M12 can be read as mutual inductance in the first coil, this phi 1, mutual inductance in the first coil due to the current in the second coil. Now we will prove that this M21 will be equal to M12, that is the mutual inductance. This will be remain same if I will, it means that if I flow the current through this coil 1, then the flux linked with the coil 2, that is suppose for the pink one, this is the coil 2 for the pink one, this is the coil 2. So because of the current through the coil 1, the flux that will link with the coil 2, that is the mutual inductance M21. And similarly, if I flow the current through the coil 2, and then there will be a magnetic field will develop across this coil 2, and so that there will be a magnetic flux will be linked through the coil 1. So that is called the, because of that, the this phenomenon is the mutual inductance, and here this is the M12, that is the mutual inductance in the first coil due to the current in the second coil. Now we will see the expression for mutual inductance. If current in coil 1 is I1, then the magnetic field in it, that is the magnetic field in this coil 1, is equal to mu naught, suppose N1, into I1. So that the flux linked with one turn of second coil, with the one turn of second coil, that is phi 2, will be equal to mu naught N1 I1 into A1, and here A1 will be less than A2. Let me write it simply as phi. This is simply phi. Okay. So this phi equal to mu naught N1 I1 into A1, and here A1 is less than A2. Why? Because the flux always, let me write, because the flux always link in small area. Since here we are considering A1 is less than A2, so here the flux will be linked, can be written as mu naught N1 I1 into A1. And similarly, we can write the flux linked with all turns of the second coil that is equal to, suppose here I am writing capital Phi, that is equal to mu naught N1 I1 that is A1 into N2. Similarly, as in case of self-inductance, we have considered for first one turn, and that after we have considered for the total number of turns. So this Phi equal to this much. Now the mutual inductance can be written M21, that is equal to mutual inductance M21 will be equal to, since Phi is proportional to I, we have written Phi equal to MI. So that will be, M will be equal to Phi divided by, so this will be Phi, capital Phi divided by I. So in place of Phi, I can write mu naught N1 I1 A1 N2 divided by I1, or this is simply, this M21 is equal to mu naught I1 I1 get cancelled. So this will be mu naught N1 A1 into N2, or in place of N2, this N2 can be written as, this is the number of turn density into the length L, into the length L, because turn density equal to number of turns for the length. That's why this N2 is the number of turns and small N2 is the number of turn density. That's why this small N2 into L. So if I'll put in this equation, this will be M21 will be equal to mu naught N1 N2 L into A1. This is the mutual inductance. Let me write. This is the mutual inductance, this M21. Okay, this M21 is the mutual inductance at coil 2 due to current at coil 1. Similarly, if I'll consider the current through the coil 2 is suppose I2, then in that case B2 will be equal to mu naught N2 I2, and the flux linked with the one turn of the first coil. Here the current is flowing through the second coil. So magnetic field will be equal to mu naught N2 I2. So the flux through the first coil will be mu naught N2 I2 into the area A1 into the area will be A1, because A1 is less than A2. So flux linked with the small area we will calculate. So phi equal to mu naught N2 I2 into A1. So now for the total number of turns, for the all turns of the coil, that is for the first coil. So in that case, the flux will be equal to mu naught N2. The current will be I2. Again, area A1. And this N will be N1. And similarly, if I will calculate for M12, so our magnetic field, let me write it here. Magnetic field is mu naught N2 I2 for the coil 2. Here we have considered for the, let me write, this is for the coil 2. So the flux linked with the number of turns is 1. When the number of turns is 1, then the flux linked with the first coil, this will be equal to mu naught N2 I2 into A1. A1, because A1 is the smallest area and flux will always link to the small area. And similarly, if I will calculate for the total number of turns, this will be equal to mu naught N2 I2 A1 into the capital N1. And if I will calculate the mutual inductance, that is M12, that is the mutual inductance in the first coil due to the current in the second coil. So this will be equal to mu naught N2 I2 A1 N1 divided by phi divided by I2. This M12 equal to capital phi divided by I2. So this value here I am substituting. So this phi divided by I2 will be equal to I2 get cancelled. This will be equal to mu 2 N2 A1, and in place of N1 we can write N1 will be equal to small N1 into L. So this will be N1 into L. Or simply we can write it as this is equal to, this is the M12 equal to this much. M12 will be equal to mu naught N1 into A1 into L. Now if I'll compare with this M21, you can see here this M12 value is here. The value of M21, here it is the value of M21. This is also mu naught N1 N2 L into A1. And here also the value of M12 is same. So here we can write this M12 value will be equal to M21, and that is equal to M. Okay. That is the mutual inductance will be same. That is, it will not depend. It will not depend on the coil through which will flow the current. Okay. So this is all about self-inductance. And here is the derivation of the self-inductance and the mutual inductance here. And here we have proved that M21 will be equal to M12. So the basic difference between the self-inductance and mutual inductance is that in case of the self-inductance, here you can see, here we need a single coil. In a single coil, we will flow the current, or we will pass the current through a single coil so that a magnetic field will develop. And because of this magnetic field, flux will generate and the flux will try to induce. And because of the change in flux, an EMF will be induced in it. But in case of the mutual inductance, we need two coils or more than one coil, so that here we'll pass the current through one coil so that an induced EMF will be generated through the other coil. So this is the basic difference between the self-inductance and the mutual inductance. This is all for today. If you like the video, hit the like button, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.